By the time the promised Messiah completed his earthly sojourn and returned to his Maker on May 26, 1908, the whole territory now known as Nigeria had already been subjugated by colonialism, and it was only 6 years after that modern Nigeria would be born through the amalgamation of northern and southern protectorates of the territories administered by the Royal Niger Company. By this time, a new era had been established by colonialism, and Islamic education was more or less in disarray. A new order had been installed, and the old order was caving in. The great Sokoto Caliphate had ended with its partition in 1903, a development that witnessed the transfer of the power of the Sultan to the High Commissioner. Of course, Christianity was a triumphant march, riding on the waves of the colonial success. It was at this auspicious moment of apparent backwardness of Muslims in Nigeria that Ahmadiyya appeared on the scene to champion the causes of education, health, and development using the platform of Islam. While it could be stated that the Ahmadiyya Jamaat was formally established in 1916, other accounts suggested that a small band of individuals had accepted Ahmadiyya previously in 1914. Muslims in Nigeria, therefore, owe Ahmadiyya a debt of gratitude for first bridging the gap between Islam and Western education, which was initially conceived as an interloper by the old order religious scholars. As a matter of fact, there was a time during the colonial period when, and I quote, "a good citizen in Nigeria and elsewhere meant one who was African by blood, Christian by religion, and British or French by culture and intellect. All others who were Muslims, animists, and so on were only tolerated and accommodated," as Fafunwa noted. Foremost among the organizations that proved that one could be a good citizen without being Christian by religion or being British or French in culture is Ahmadiyya, against the backdrop of the emphasis the organization placed on formal education without compromising the extant Islamic faith. It is on record, for instance, that the first Muslim school in Nigeria was established by the Ahmadiyya, and the same thing is applicable to the first Muslim hospital and the Muslim newspaper. Since the organization became a rallying point for the Muslim elite when it was birthed in Nigeria in 1916, there's no doubt that many successes have been recorded in all spheres of human endeavor. In spite of challenges the Jamaat has faced in its quest for existence, relevance, and acceptance, we cannot deny the fact that the Ahmadiyya movement is regarded as heterodox by the majority of mainstream Muslims. And Ahmadiyya Muslims have been marginalized, discriminated against in various ways, and sometimes violently oppressed, particularly in Pakistan, where they were categorized as a non-Muslim minority in national law through the efforts of political and religious leaders in 1974. Nonetheless, Ahmadiyya Muslims and organizations are active in educational, missionary, and community efforts. There also exists a Sufi brotherhood called the Ahmadiyya, popular in Sudan and Egypt, which was unrelated to the Ahmadiyya movement.